yes, he is. Yes, he is. God, my Savior.
God, my Savior.
Everybody that knows he's a healer, say it.
Minister Roger Anderson is a licensed and ordained minister of the gospel who considers himself a systematic theologian. He is an avid researcher of Jewish biblical history and holds an associate's degree in biblical history. He is the CEO of the To Simply Serve podcast and To Simply Serve LLC. He also hosts the Righteousness, a weight loss program where he cooks and shares healthy recipes and ministry on righteousness and right living. He enjoys being a husband, father, grandfather, and personal trainer.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise God. Praise God. We greet you in the precious name of Jesus Christ, our Savior, our Lord, our Redeemer, our soon coming King, man of God. It's a pleasure to have you in the house. We have also Dr. Jason Gray in here with us. Greetings.
Yes, greetings, sir. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. How are you guys?
We're blessed and highly favored, I tell you.
Wonderful, yes. Wonderful, man of God.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. I'm
good
so
to
good.
See you in the house of the Lord on this blessed day.
Yes, Lord, it is truly a blessed day to be alive and see the manifestation of God's grace and his mercy on us every day. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I just stopped by here this morning with this message. I had previously worked on another message, but God had different plans, and he changed that message for me and told me that this is what I want you to say this morning, regardless of how it looks and how it sounds and who it affects. I need for you to get this word in the earth. And so I'm going to do exactly what God told me to do. And this sermon that I'm going to preach this morning is alluding to that same fact. I will be taking this text from Numbers 22, verse 1 through 38. It's a story that is going to take me that many verses to really to say what I, you know, what God has told me to say. So the title of my sermon is A Lesson That Can Be Learned from a Donkey. We in this present time, we've got so many things that can distract us and get us away from our purpose. And our purpose should be connected to God. And so we are going to start this morning off with reading the text. The text is coming from Numbers 22, chapter 22, verses 1 through 38. And I'm going to read that to the audience. Chapter 22, Numbers chapter 22, verse 1. The Israelites set out and camped in the plains of Moab, across the Jordan from Jericho. Now Balak, son of Zippor, saw all that Israel had done to the Amorites. Verse 3, Moab was in great dread of the people because they were so numerous. God had just brought them out of Egypt and they had multiplied while they were in Egypt and they were marching towards the promised land. And they camped out near the Amorites. And they were in dread of them. Moab was overcome with fear of the people of Israel. And Moab said to the elders of Midian, this horde will now lick up all that is around us, as an ox licks up the grass of the field. Now Balak, son of Zippor, was king of Moab at the time. He sent messengers to Balaam. Balaam was a diviner, son of Beor and Pethah, which is on the Euphrates in the land of Amor, to summon him, saying, a people has come out of Egypt. They have spread over the face of the earth, and they have settled next to me. How many of you all know that when people know that you are the righteous and you settle next to them, they become uncomfortable. They become unnerved just by your presence, and they feel like they're going to be overtaken by your righteousness. Okay, we're at verse 6 now. Come now, curse this people for me, since they are stronger than I. Perhaps I shall be able to defeat them and drive them from the land. For I know that whomever you bless is blessed, and whomever you curse is cursed. Balak must have thought Balaam was a powerful man to say those words like that. But Balak didn't know where Balaam was getting his power from. So the elders of Moab, this is verse 7. So the elders of Moab and the elders of Midian departed with the fees for divination in their hand. And they came to Balaam and gave him Balak's message. Verse 8, he said to them, stay here tonight. This is Balaam talking. Stay here tonight, and I will bring back word to you just as the Lord speaks to me. Now, Balaam was living in a land of idolatry. These were idolaters here. They didn't believe in the power of the living God. They worship idols and divination. But what they didn't know about Balaam was, even though he was a diviner, he knew where he got or where he was getting his power from. Do you know where you're getting your power from today? Balaam knew. Do you know where you're getting your power today when we are living in a land of idolatry, a land that idolizes people, that idolizes material things, that idolizes what's in front of the eye instead of what's in the spirit world, the unseen world of God? Well, Balaam knew where he was getting his power from. He knew that. And so Balaam asked him to spend the night. He said that I will bring back a word to you just as the Lord speaks to me. So the officials of Moab stayed with Balaam. God came to Balaam that night and said, why are these men with you, Balaam? Said God. Then Balaam said, King Balaam, son of Zippor. King Balaam, son of Zippor, God came and he said, King Balaam has sent me a message. God sent me a message. He said, a people has come out of Egypt and has spread over the face of the earth. Now come and curse me. This is the entourage that Balak had sent that is speaking, and they have spread over the face of the earth. Now come, curse them for me. Perhaps I shall be able to fight against them and drive them out. And God said to Balaam, you shall not go with them. You shall not curse the people, for they are blessed.
I am at verse 13 now. So Balaam rose in the morning and said to the officials of Balak, go to your own land, for the Lord has refused to let me go with you. The Lord refused to let Balaam go with them. So the officials of Moab rose and went to Balak and said, Balaam refuses to come with us. Verse 15, once again, Balak sent officials more numerous and more distinguished than these. They came to Balaam and said to him, thus says Balak, son of Zippor, do not let anything hinder you from coming to me, for I will surely do you great honor, and whatever you say to me, I will do. Come, curse this people for me. Verse 18, but Balaam replied to the servants of Balak, although Balak were to give me to his house full of silver and gold, I could not go beyond the command of the Lord of my God to do less or more. Verse 19, you remain here as the others did, so that I may learn what more the Lord may say to me. That night, God came to Balaam and said to him, if the men have come to summon you, get up and go with them, but do only what I tell you to do. Do only what I tell you to do. So Balaam got up in the morning, saddled his donkey, and went out with the officials of Moab. He got up and went out with the officials of Moab. Now, God has already told him not to go, but he got up anyway. God was angry with him. Verse 22, God's anger was kindled because he was going, and the angel of the Lord took his stand in the road as his adversary. Now he was riding on the donkey, and his two servants were with him. Verse 23, the donkey saw the angel of the Lord standing in the road with a drawn sword in his hand. So the donkey turned off the road and went into the field, and Balaam struck the donkey to turn it back onto the road. 24, then the angel of the Lord stood in a narrow path between the vineyards with a wall on either side. And when the donkey saw the angel of the Lord, it scraped against the wall. It crushed his foot against the wall and scraped it some skin off so that he struck it again. Balaam beat the donkey again. 26, then the angel of the Lord went ahead and stood in a narrow place where there was no way to turn either to the right or to the left. When the donkey saw the angel of the Lord, it lay down under Balaam. And Balaam's anger was kindled, and he struck the donkey with his staff. Then the Lord opened the mouth of the donkey, and it said to Balaam, what have you done? What have you done to you? What have I done to you that you would have struck me these three times? Balaam said to the donkey, because you have made a fool of me, I wish I had a sword in my hand, and I would have killed you right now. But the donkey said to Balaam, am I not your donkey, which you have ridden all your life to this day? Have I been in the habit of treating you this way? And he said, no. Then the Lord opened the eyes of Balaam, and he saw the angel of the Lord standing in the road with his drawn sword in his hand, and he bowed down, falling on his face. Verse 32. The angel of the Lord said to him, why have you struck your donkey these three times? I have come out as an adversary because your way is perverse before me. The donkey saw me and turned away from these three times. If it had not turned away from me, surely just now I would have killed you, and I let you live. Then Balaam said to the angel of the Lord, I have sinned, for I did not know that you were standing in the road to oppose me. Now, therefore, if it is displeasing to you, I will return home. Verse 35, the angel of the Lord said to Balaam, go with the men, but speak only what I tell you to speak. So Balaam went out with the officials of Balak. Now we have this tremendous story here that we can learn some lessons from. Even though Balaam was disobedient, God gave him a second chance. You see, God is about giving second chances. And the reason God gave Balaam a second chance, because in my mind, God knew that Balaam actually knew that he was Lord of the breakthrough, that he was omnipotent, that even though he was the God of Israel, he knew that, Balaam knew that he got his power from God. And we have to know today that our power comes from God. It doesn't come from man. It doesn't come from some happenstance, or it doesn't come from saying words over and over again. It doesn't come from the moon. It doesn't come from the stars. It comes from God. And there are some lessons to be learned from this donkey. Because in this story, we saw that Balak was afraid that Israel was going to wipe them out. He thought that Israel was going to take everything that he had worked for. You know, we see some people like that. You know, they think that someone or somebody is going to take everything that they have, that they work for. They're going to come and just literally obliterate them. But the thing about it is, what Balak did, he called on someone other than God. Have there been times that you have called on someone other than God and you got off focus and got distracted and you thought, and you didn't have time to wait on God, so you called on something else, or you started to go your own path? Have you been like that before, only to find out that God hadn't gone anywhere, that you had to come back to God because what you thought was working wasn't working out for you? So, and then you call on somebody that you thought was had the power to do that for you. And that's what Balak thought. He thought that Balaam had the power to obliterate the Israelites that had scattered all over the land, and they were had encamped near him. So what do we say about this lesson in focus? Because Balaam stayed focused. He stayed focused, and Balaam knew that if he stayed focused, that he would continue to have the power of the Lord. So when they said, spend the night here, what did Balaam do? Balaam said, let me consult with the Lord first. Do we do that when we're having hard times, when we are distracted and we feel like everything that has had, we've tried hasn't worked, and that, you know, we've tried so hard that things are not really going our way? Do we consult the Lord? Do we filter our thoughts, our meditations, the things that we worry about? Do we filter that through the Word of God? No, sometimes we don't. So we get distracted, but just like Balaam, just like God told Balaam in Numbers 22 and 12, he said, do not go with them. You, please, do not go with them. You must not put a curse on these people because they are blessed. You are blessed. You are blessed. God has told some Balaam out there not to put a curse on you if you stay in his word. Because you are blessed. You are a blessed people. You are under the protection and the wings of God. And so what Balaam did, here he comes, he sends more officials. You know, he sent that update. He sent that update to you. You know, he sent that remodel and repackage that thing. That's what the devil will do to make it look good to you so he can get you distracted. So Balaam stayed focused, you know, for a while, but then he got distracted and he went. And he went. And the thing about it is, even though he went, he still said, no, I cannot curse these people. But when he went, God got angry with him. And the angel of the Lord stood in the road to oppose him. And Balaam was riding on the donkey when this happened. And see, apparently that is when Balaam lost his focus while he was on the donkey. And when he was on the donkey, it is my guess that he started to rethink why he was going and what was the ulterior motive. And maybe, you know, he got to thinking about the money that he could make. And maybe he was thinking about, you know, the cars that he could buy, you know, the coach bags, the red bottom shoes that he could obtain. And then three times, the donkey saw the angel, and Balaam didn't see the angel. And Balaam got mad with the donkey because the donkey was seeing the angels, and this angel had a sword in his hand, and he was turning away, going the other direction. So three times that happened. And then, you know, you got a lot of people that think that God made the donkey talk, but God did not make that donkey talk. God spoke through the donkey. He spoke through the donkey, and God can speak through you. And I tell you this, I don't mind being a donkey for God. Because if someone can come up to me and tell me that and see me doing what I'm doing now, and they say, you know, I think that I can do that just like he is doing, then God make me a donkey. If I can tell someone that they're going to have a good day and God is speaking to me to bless somebody, then God make me a donkey. God speak through me. God speak through me. And so what we find out after that is, you know, when God has spoken through this donkey, and Balaam must have thought the donkey was crazy. But one thing that I'm continually learning about God is that he is greater and more creative than we can ever imagine. And I am willing to open myself up to letting him do what he can and what he wants to do. And sometimes, you know, I find myself saying to myself, God wouldn't do that. Or either I will have a theological stance or a limit on God. You can't put limits on God. God can speak through a donkey. You can't put limits on him. You know, and that the lesson number two is this, is that God can do whatever he wants to do. And once you realize that, you will know that you will find out that God will do miraculous things through you too. And we also know that we cannot get tired of doing well. We can't get distracted out here these days. You know, when Balaam was beating that donkey, and the donkey asked him, say, why are you beating me like this? You know, we know in the Bible tells us that, you know, things have gotten so bad that the rocks will cry out. You know, nature cries out when so much sin is in the world, when so much rebellion is in the world. So that is why we have to be so careful about who is speaking to us and putting theological limits on God. So we will find out that God is a God that is high and he looks low. He knows the beginning from the end, and that he's trying to open our eyes, because sometimes he'll send a donkey to you and it'll be in the form of a human being. It can be in the form of a rock. It can be in the form of the wind. We know that he spoke to Elijah in the cave in a whisper. We know he spoke to Abraham in a burning bush. God is good at speaking through donkeys. So it will behoove us to look out and not get distracted, to filter through his word and look for the donkeys, because there are many, many donkeys, I'm sure, that we have encountered through life, but we didn't listen because it didn't look like what we thought it should look like. It didn't speak the way that we thought it should speak. It didn't have the status that we thought it should have. It didn't have $1 million in his bank account. It didn't have a PhD, a BS degree. It didn't have a master degree. It didn't have CEO in front of his name. So we didn't want to listen to the donkey, but sometimes we have to listen to the donkey, because even though the donkey may not look like it ought to look, it may not be packaged the way that we think it should package, but the lesson is that we can't get distracted. The lesson is that we have to stay focused, and the lesson is we have to stay in God's word to know when God is speaking to us. Because the Bereans were a Jewish Christian sect, and they, when they heard the word, they would go back and study the word. You know, they didn't just take what looked like a donkey. They didn't just take that donkey's word. They went back and they examined that word. And that's why we have to stay in the word and read that word, so that we can filter the word through the word of God, because it is the word of God, but he's also the God of the word. Hallelujah. And I'm so glad that today that we have Christians, we have believers out there that know when they see the Balaks, they know when the donkey is speaking, they know when God is whispering, they know when God is in the wind, they know when God is in the rock crying out, they know God when he's in the clouds, they know the angel that's standing in the road with the sword, trying to veer you, trying to steer you, trying to prick you to go the way that you should go. And God gave Balaam a second chance. He's the God of the second chance. How can you not love a God like that? Man won't give you a second. Most men won't give you a second chance, especially when they think that they can get promoted by stepping on your foot or on your back. But God is a God of the second chances. So have your faith in him and believe in him. And don't worry about what it looks like. Don't worry about what it smells like. When the donkey comes to you, don't rebel. Listen to the donkey. Listen to the donkey. And I'm going to close with this. We are a divided nation. We are divided people in Christendom now, in the Christian world. We have to come together as one entity in Christ. And I hope for this dispensation that we can come together and stop rebelling against God, thinking that we are right, because this donkey doesn't look like the donkey that should be bringing the word of God. And I thank you today for letting me speak into your ear. And may God bless you richly. Amen.
Praise God, praise God. We receive. Thank you, Jesus.
This is the Upper Room. We are here every Sunday from 8 a.m. until 12 noon Eastern Standard Time. Call us to submit your prayer request, and we'll be sure to lift up your petition to the Lord. Call the Upper Room on 404-464-8785. Meet us right here on 106 Inspiration and 106LiveRadio.com. ...106 R&B and Throwbacks on 106 Live Radio. Radio. Atlanta's music leader.
Streaming live from Atlanta to a global audience on your favorite device from Source of Wellness Media, we are 106inspiration.com.
Here is your invitation to leave behind the noise and distractions of the week. Come into the Upper Room for an authentic worship experience. Sundays from 8 a.m. until 12 noon on 106 Inspiration and 106LiveRadio.com.
Say bless.
Yeah!
Since there was walked to red land, as a light in a dark land. Since thou was placed in thy heart, all the Lord's commands. He sent thee up of nations and cast thy enemies. fades away. You stand here within me. So let me hear you say, you place it in his hand. So my horse rides up against thee to giants for the day. They're rushing we're on to harm thee, but they'll flee.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, for confirming your word today. It was only on yesterday that we were repeating these words that God gives people second chances. And everyone deserves a second chance. As we found out, you know, that God has people already set up in places for you. And it is so key this morning as we heard Minister Anderson speak the word of truth right here in the upper room, that God can speak in many different ways. And we don't want to deny the access of God's voice. We don't want to tune his voice out because we fail to listen to the channel or the conduit in which God chooses to use. Today, we are truly blessed to hear this message from Minister Anderson, Roger Anderson. He came in with a powerful word, lessons from a donkey. Some people don't want to take heed to even the children around us. They don't want to listen to the circumstances in which God would speak through. They don't want to listen to a dog, much less for a donkey, you know, but God is going to speak in multiple ways. He's going to speak in dreams. He's going to speak in visions. He's going to speak to your heart. He's going to speak through the mouths of babes, children. He's going to speak to people who we consider lesser in our society. He's going to speak through animals. And he's going to speak through nature. God is going to speak. He will not stop short of using anything to come to us. And the reason why God would have to speak through the donkey, as we heard today, is because he spoke to the man of God, Balaam, no, do not go. You cannot curse what I've already blessed.
And he thought he can get away with that. He thought he can do his own thing. And here's the thing, you know, Balaam certainly got a rude awakening. It took him a little longer to understand that God was serious, and he meant what he said, you know, do not go with these gentlemen. But he thought he would go anyway because that's what he wanted to do. That was something that was within him. And it's amazing how God uses circumstances to get his message across. And in this case, he used a donkey to get his message across that this is not something you want to do. And the beautiful thing is the donkey seen in the spirit realm what was going on, and his eyes were just completely blind because he was walking in disobedience. Had he have been walking in obedience, he wouldn't have been there, and he wouldn't have gone through the trauma that he had went through, only to realize that God said that this is not what you want to do here. And yes, he beat the donkey out of frustration, out of anger. And let's just say that Balaam decided to get off the donkey and to proceed on foot. There would have been the end of it. It would have been a different ending to that story because he would have certainly gotten struck down by the angel. I mean, the angel was there to obviously be a barrier between him and going there. And the angel had a special assignment to take him out if he needs to. But thank God he didn't have to do that because God opened his eyes after he had a conversation with the donkey. And God can use anything, any person, weather, situation to speak through that individual or speak through that animal to get your attention. So yeah, God didn't make the donkey speak. God spoke through the donkey. And even with that conversation, you know, Balaam was still angry and was actually thinking that he was talking to the donkey. in essence, he was actually speaking to God. And then when God revealed to him what was going on, it was like, wow, I sinned.
Donkey was a conduit for God to speak.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
And he would put writings on the wall.
He's done that.
He would whisper in your ear and terrify you.
Done that.
Should you fall asleep.
Done that.
Yeah, he will come because he's a God and he says, I do not change. The word of God in Malachi says, I remain faithful to my covenant. And he does not want us to end in ruin, to go put curses on people that would reverse and bounce back into our lives. He doesn't want that. He doesn't want us to fall into a pit and in a trap. You know, when they set up the hole for Daniel, it wasn't designed, you know, to create these residual problems. Stop while you're at it. God wants us to stop while we're at it. Don't dig pits for people. You might fall in it, but God is so faithful. He does not want us to come to an end that is destructive. He wants us to be in a place whereby we can continue to grow in our faith and our love. We heard today, keep dwelling in that secret place with God. Keep staying focused on his word. His word is true. We ought to study, like the word of God says, to show ourselves approved. We ought to be those workmen who are not ashamed, but keep on studying the word of God. God's going to speak. And if we don't know what his voice sounds like, we're in trouble.
And you and I, Tinasha, was listening to something the other day, and it was yesterday actually, and the minister said that as humans, sometimes it's okay to ask questions to God, but it's not okay to question God as far as the motives. And I think that would have been a moment where he probably would have, you know, questioned God on why is it that you don't want me to go? And that's dangerous water to get into if you start doing that. You know, he certainly didn't understand why God didn't want him to go. And of course, you know, yeah, he wanted, you know, something, a different outcome. But again, God's will be done no matter what. And like you say, you know, whoever God blesses, no man can curse. It just isn't happening that way. There's nothing. I mean, whether you go and you try to take matters into your own hand and again, you may fall into that trap that you set for that other person. We see it time and time again in the Bible where people set traps and they end up falling in it, or they end up being hung by their own gallows, or being eaten up by the lions that they put in the den, or what have you. So you just have to be obedient to the word of God. You have to be obedient when God tells you not to do it. Don't question him. Just go with it. God has never led you wrong.
That's right. And we also see there that the other point that Balaam sought the Lord. And I love that, but we got to listen after God speaks. So seeking God is great. We see kings seeking God. We see many people seeking after the voice of God. And when the king of Moab sought for him to come and God said, no, you cannot curse these people because I have blessed them. That's enough. It's going to return to sender. It's going to spring back around.
Yep.
And so thank God for second chances. Thank God that he's overseeing all things. Why? Because he's not like man that he should lie. Numbers tells us that. Neither the son of man to repent, right? If he said it, he will do it. If he speak it, it's going to happen. God says, you cannot curse these people because I have blessed them. And we want to encourage someone today that you are blessed, no matter the arena that you're tested and tried in. Keep on being who God has called you to be. You are blessed. You're not necessarily have to seek after blessings anymore. You are the blessed one. You are the radiant one. You are the child that God has died for already. It is now your opportunity to return and say yes to the Master. Take his right hand of righteousness and continue to walk in synchronization with him, because indeed he has more in store for us. Any final thoughts?
Final thoughts is this here, folks. When you do seek God and you're asking for direction, whatever answer God gives to you, be obedient to it.
Amen.
Do not try to take matters into your own hand. Do not think that, oh, God, didn't really mean that, and this is my interpretation. Take it for face value. When God said something, it is absolute. Doesn't change.
Absolute. There is a blessing for your obedience. Stay in obedience. We were going to pray for you. Someone here today is listening. We're going to ask Jason to pray. Pray as the Lord would lead him. Giving people hope, knowing that there is a day when the fullness of time will come and God is going to reveal to you exactly what he've already said in the secret place. It's just going to be a demonstration of the things that he've already ministered to you. And so we want you to stay on course. Know that God has not fallen short. He has not forgotten you. He has not dropped the ball. He has not forgotten about the promise that he made with you and the covenant that you've set with you. Keep your altar erected so that God can function based on the fact that you are already praying and you're standing there with the substance of faith. Stay in faith. Stay in faith. Don't give up. God is coming through for you. We believe. Hashtag any moment now in Jesus' name. Jason, would you pray?
Absolutely. Heavenly Father, most gracious God, we look to you today, Lord, for our hope. Eternal life, Lord. And Lord, as we are praying here, there are so many people in this world right now that are hurting, going through many, many situations right now, more than I can even imagine, or we can even just, you know, rattle off here. But Lord, as we pray for these people, and prayer, there's no distance in prayer. And when we pray, Lord, for, you know, salvation. We pray, Lord, for restoration of family, of marriages, of finances, the things that the enemy has taken from you. Lord, we ask you, Lord, that you will just give people the time back that they deserve, Lord. You know, the canker worms. We know yes. that the canker worm, the job of them is just to eat up time, to take it away from us, Lord. So, Lord, those things that have prevented us from really experiencing the fullness of you, Lord, we pray, Lord, that you would restore those things. Restore to us our salvation that we have lost, Lord, that we have traded, Lord, yes, for time, Lord. For money, and for all these things, Lord. Jesus. And Lord, we live in a society now where bad is good and good is bad now. And I pray, Lord, that, you know, we can get back to the true calling, Lord, that you have yes. placed on our lives, Lord. It's to serve you, Lord. It's to bring pleasure to you, Lord. Yes. Help us to be good stewards of the things that you have blessed us with, the things that you've entrusted us with, Lord, our children, Lord. Help us to sharpen the little arrows, Lord. All of us, Lord, at some point can be a mentor to the youth out there, whether you're a biological father or mother or you're segregate. Lord, we pray, Lord, that you'll just equip us with the tools necessary to make those things happen. And the things that are going on in the world, we absolutely, we see these things that are happening. There are lots of things going on, you know, wars, even rumors of wars, Lord. And we know that wars is usually conflicts between other countries, but we pray, Lord, that peace would just transpire here, Lord, that people of different nations and different countries, Lord, would be able to come to terms, come up with treaties, Lord, that would promote and foster peace, because we need to live in a society where we can come together in unity. And Lord, we pray for the next generation of children and those that are behind us who we're handing off the baton to, Lord, that they'll keep what we've sown into them, that they won't try to go off course and do things wickedly, Lord, because we know that, you know, once the wickedness starts, it's just like a wildfire. So, you know, we rebuke the plan of the enemy, because the enemy out there wants to see death and destruction. His plan is to kill, steal, and destroy. And we know, Lord, that you came here to provide eternal life for us, Lord. So we seek the light. Light will always win over darkness, Lord. So I pray, Lord, that our light will be strong, will be so bright that the enemy cannot even stand to be in our presence, Lord. And we pray for deliverance, Lord, for people who have been bewitched, that has been hexed, yes. that has been placed in situations where they have no idea what's going on with their mind. You know, we see this happening not only here in the United States, but also abroad, especially in countries in Africa where, you know, witchcraft is very prevalent, Lord. So we pray, Lord, that, you know, whoever is experiencing witchcraft or any of those things, Lord, that the spell would be broken in the name of Jesus, that all strongholds that the enemy has placed will be cast down. All spiritual wicked altars that have been placed up will be broken down and destroyed and bulldozed over, Lord. Lord, you have really opened many doors for all of us here, Lord. And as those that are listening right now can just, you know, only imagine that, you know, and believe that God is going to be there for you. God is working. And, you know, like I said, there's no distance in prayer. You know, we can pray here and it can be impactful on all four corners of the earth. So we just continue to pray that this week will be a wonderful week, that Lord, your will be done, Lord, that when we have opportunities to share our faith with people, Lord, that you will speak through us, just like how you spoke through the donkey. You can speak through us, Lord. And when we open our mouth, we can say something that is so impactful that it can change the life of the person that's right in front of us, Lord. And help us, Lord, to recognize those opportunities that are in front of us, Lord, and not be blind to them, because there's opportunities all around us to do things for the kingdom, Lord. And as we put on our kingdom building hats, Lord, when those opportunities arise, Lord, that's when we ask for the boldness of the Spirit of God to come through us, Lord. Allow us to operate our business with kingdom principles and kingdom economics, because we know that kingdom economics never fails, Lord. And we pray, Lord, for a transformation in the way we do things, Lord, even inside of the school systems, even inside of our workplace, our place of employment, Lord, and even how we even manage our households, Lord. We want to completely change our mindsets, Lord, and focus on the higher level things, the kingdom living, Lord, because that's what you know, that's what it's all about. We live in a world, in a dimension where there's all sorts of systems, Lord, and I pray, Lord, that we can get out of the system, the economic system that we're in here, where it just doesn't work, Lord. We know that kingdom economics work all the way, Lord. And allow us again to renew our minds, Lord. Yes. Allow us to be, again, impactful and influential around the people that we're around. That when people see us, they see you through us, Lord. That when they look into our eyes, they see that we've had an encounter with you. Allow it to be that noticeable that people can really say, you know what, I want what you have. And again, like I said, we lift up, you know, families, relationships, Lord. Businesses, we lift up everything to you, Lord. Everything belongs to you. Nothing here on this earth belongs to us. And I'll just say, and I'll leave by saying this, that, you know, all blessings comes from God through man to man. And we know that that's how that works. And all blessings come from God and belong to you, God. And I pray, Lord, that you'll continue to bless us, continue to show us favor as we head out and we do what you've called us to do. And I give you all the praise, all the glory, and all the honor. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise God. Praise God.
Yes, and we absolutely, as we're, you know, transitioning, we certainly want to just thank the team Anderson for all they have done. Thank you, Minister Roger Anderson, for that wonderful message today, because I tell you, you can learn a lot from a donkey, and you can certainly, you know, every one of us has had those donkey moments where we were listening to all of the signs and the social and spiritual cues that God has placed before us. And sometimes it takes an act of God to really open our eyes. And we don't want to ever get to the point where it takes an act of God to move us. We want to be obedient immediately. So I pray, you know, that all of us will have that discerning spirit, that we can certainly get it right on the first time. And again, you know, we thank you so much, Minister Anderson, for bringing the word. This was refreshing and definitely in time and in season for it.
Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Well, we want to encourage you. If you've heard from God today, please take heed. He may speak once, he may speak twice, he may speak three times. We're hoping and trusting that God is going to continue to give us mercy and grace and second chances, as we've heard today. But we are grateful to have heard this message once again in this house, in this upper room. We are so grateful. Let's go ahead and be obedient, because we don't want to get to that narrow place where they say the rock, between a rock and a hard place, where you're squeezed between walls and you get crushed in the process, right? We want to be able to give our hearts freely to God and recommit and reconnect and reestablish those covenants with our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ. We encourage you to stay connected to 106 Live Radio, 106 Inspiration. We love you. We bless you in Jesus' name. Go forth in peace. Walk in that which God has already declared over your life. I believe you're blessed in the city and you're blessed in the field. You're blessed coming in. You're blessed going out. You're blessed on your way to the victory that God has already declared over you. There's a banner over you, and it's a banner of love. Praise God, that you are blessed. Amen.